Scott, your thoughts on the season so far? It's going pretty well.
Yeah, I think the win on Tuesday night helped. I think we deserve to win. I think we've been a bit unlucky not to get a few more points, to be honest. I felt we could have easily got a point or even three at Sunderland, but we had enough chances, and we was 1 minute away from getting the 3 points at Bolton as well. So I think the 3 points was deserved on Tuesday. And yeah, I think it's gone well so far.
You seem to be relishing the role that you're playing at the moment. You look very comfortable in it. And working with Mo and Troy in the way that you do, it seems like a really good trio.
Yeah, I enjoy playing with them too. When we get the ball, we know we need to help each other out, make runs, talk to each other on the pitch, and that's what we do, and yeah, I'm enjoying it.
But I presume at some point this season the competition has started for goals between the three of you, because you're all going to score goals. It's quite clear that you're all going to score goals this season, so is there a little competition going on?
There's not at the minute, no, there's not. I think as long as we keep winning, I don't mind who scores, to be honest. As long as we win the game, that's the main thing. But yeah, it's good so far.
Yeah, that's what you say to me. That's what you say to me and us here. Behind the scenes, I bet there's a competition going on. Listen, I mean, we talked about the positivity and the bright start to the season, and maybe, you know, getting something from the Sunderland game as well. There's a huge amount of buoyancy. There's a huge amount of motivation in the side at the moment. Just explain what it's been like working with Liam in the short time that you have worked with him. He seems to have got across what he wants, the small bits that he's been able to quite quickly, and have you all enjoyed working with him?
Yeah, definitely. It's been a very good start, enjoyable start. They've got over some good points that I thought took into the game well on Tuesday. And we've also done some work this week on tomorrow's game, so hopefully we can show that as well.
I know these questions have been asked a great deal recently of all footballers at all levels, but just explain what it's like playing in front of those fans. Oh, I think they were superb on Tuesday night. It was some great noise in the second half as well. Just explain what that's like.
Yeah, that's why we play football, to be honest. It's so much, it's 100 times better than when there isn't any fans. Everything means that so much more. Even stuff like tackles or the roar of the fans, just it helps so much, and it's something that I don't think as a player that you'll ever take for granted or ever forget when you're older, the fans' noise, because it means so much.
You've got the flip side of that on Saturday at Ipswich, because there'll be a lot of fans inside the ground, inside Portman Road, and a lot of fans anti-MK Dons. You're looking forward to that as well?
Yeah, it was the same at Bolton. I thought that was really good atmosphere, enjoyed that. It's just so nice having the fans back. As I say, it doesn't matter when they're against. Sometimes it's better than there being no one there. I'd rather them be loads there if they were away fans, but it's just so much better with fans in. Makes the game such a better, more atmosphere, and yeah. I think we can achieve anything we want to, really, as long as we work hard, play our way, and be brave and be clinical in both boxes. And I think we can achieve anything we want to. I think on our day, if we play well, I think we win. If we take our chances, we go into every game thinking we can win. Sort of don't see why we can't achieve that at the very top, to be honest.
Just to keep banging on that supporters' drum again. It feels like, for me anyway, that games have started a lot faster as well with supporters in the grounds. You know, a lot of times last season when there wasn't anyone in, that it felt a little bit like it was a training game and you still felt each other out for maybe the first 20 minutes or so. Do you feel that there's been more of a fast start from both sets of teams with supporters in and the roaring you on?
Yeah, I think the supporters, it gives every player, I think, 10% extra, and that's shown in the first 10 minutes or so, and especially that's why you see such fast starts, because everyone wants to win the games, everyone wants to do it for the fans, everyone wants to do it for the teammates and when the fans are there, it's like an extra player. It's such a difference, and I think, yeah, that's why the starts have been so quick compared to, as you say, something like last year where there wasn't no fans and it seemed like a training game. Obviously, we still wanted to win just as much, but it just gives you that little bit of a boost when the fans are there.
And we've spoken about, you know, the team making a solid start. You've seemed to have slotted in perfectly, and you know, with goals and assists to your name already, you must be eager to keep going with that and getting your numbers up.
Yeah, there's a lot of competition for place in this team. It's a very strong squad, so just want to keep my place, keep playing well, and keep the team winning, and hopefully we can have a good season together.
Nice one, thanks, mate.
Cheers.
Scott, a lot has been said about the collective age of the Dons squad. You yourself are slap bang in the middle, nice young player going there, and how has that helped you and some of the newer players sort of gel, being all of a relatively similar sort of age?
Yeah, I think it probably does help. It's a very good change room. Everyone gets on with everyone. We're always having a laugh with each other. And we can also, when it isn't going so well, we can also know that we need to get on to each other sometimes, and it's nothing personal. We know that. We got the respect of each other that if we're not tracking a runner or something, we can tell each other, and there's a respect there that need to keep working hard, and everyone's got to give 100% all the time, and we all know that.
The last one for me. A stat came out the other day saying that you were the most fouled player so far in League One. Do you think that your willingness to take on opposition defenders, your pace and your control of the ball draws opponents into making those sorts of mistakes and giving your team opportunities with set pieces?
Yeah, it might be that. I think areas where I get on the ball where I've got runners like Troy and Mo, I think sometimes if they might feel they need to, I'm not sure. But it helps when I've got people running off, so I can play balls through, hopefully maybe a bit more. A bit like I did for Troy's goal the other night on Tuesday, I think that helps. So, yeah.